Grateful people, lovers of freedom all over the world, I bring greetings from a grateful heart. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening for wherever you might be watching me from. I do appreciate your support always on this channel. I am grateful. In case you are seeing my face for the first time, I am Agatha Progress Channel here on YouTube, and I come across your way every blessed day. Do well to support Biafra referendum, because in Biafra, we shall rejoice together. All right, I have a wonderful video here that I want us to watch together. I don't know how you felt about it, but I do hope you pick some sense from it. Now, here is the video. Watch it, and I will be right back.
Ajali police station on fire. Ajali police station. People are trapped. Nekwa unknown gunmen. Abasa people, Basa people, Mandi police. Nekwa police in car. God ordinary. Ajali police station on fire. People are still trapped inside. Everybody should be careful. Today is 30th September. People are inside. We are trying to rescue some people inside. People are inside. Okuna Aba people inside. Ajali police station. 30th. Unknown men gone. Unknown gunmen on fire. Madden on it. Anna Choka Malinaga, Bob Tonya. Onye no nime. Mmadu ka no nime eba. Mmadu no nime eba. Chineke mela anya bela. Onwa yafu.
I come from Lebanon. I was born and raised in Lebanon, which used to be the only majority Christian country in the Middle East. We were open-minded, we were fair, we were tolerant, we were multicultural. We prided ourselves in our multiculturalism. We had open border policy. We welcomed everyone to come to our country because we wanted to share with them the westernization which we had created in the heart of the Arabic world. Muslims used to send their children to study in our universities because we had built the best universities in the Arabic world. They graduated and worked in our economy because we had built the best economy in the Middle East, even though we did not have any oil. Beirut became Paris of the Middle East, the banking capital of the Middle East. In 1965, National Geographic magazine had on its front cover, Lebanon, Eden of the Middle East. Unfortunately, all this began to change as the years went by. See, we got our independence in the early 40s. But by the 60s and 70s, the Christians had become the minority and the Muslims had become the majority in Lebanon. And as the Islamic population grew in the country became less and less tolerant because they started pushing for more rights that were not compatible with our Judeo-Christian value system that we had created. And that's when the problem started. The problem was contained until the influx of the Palestinians out of Jordan in 1970, when Lebanon brought them in because we already had refugee camps. Actually, at that time, Lebanon was the only country in the Middle East to accept the third wave of Palestinians into Lebanon. The majority of them were Muslims. They put their heads together with the Muslims in Lebanon and declared jihad on the Christians. What they wanted to do is create a base from which to fight Israel, kill the Jews, and throw them into the sea. Something they tried to do in Jordan. Yasser Arafat and the Palestinians tried to do in Jordan, but they failed because of the dictatorship of the king. Yet they were able to come to Lebanon, use our open-mindedness, our fairness, our tolerance, our multiculturalism, and our democracy to topple our democracy. My 9/11 happened to me in 1975 when radical Muslims blew up my home, bringing it down, burying me under the rubble wounded as they shouted Allahu Akbar. My only crime was that I was a Christian living in a Christian town. I ended up in a hospital for 2.5 months. And as I laid in a hospital bed, hooked up to IVs in both arms, I would ask my parents, why did they do this to us? Why did they attack us? And my father would tell me, because we are Christians, the Muslims consider us infidels and they want to kill us. So I knew since I was a 10-year-old child that I am wanted dead simply because I was born into the Christian faith and lived in a Christian town. This is something so foreign to Christians in America. Because in America, our idea of persecution is, oh, I took my Bible with me to work today and people looked at me funny. That's our idea of persecution. Where I come from, our idea of persecution is they want to walk into this church and start shooting at you and killing you. Just like what they're doing in Iraq right now, just like what they're doing in Egypt right now, just like what they're doing in Syria, just like what they did in Lebanon. Actually, what launched the all-out war in Lebanon was four Muslims walked into a church service on a Sunday morning just like this and started shooting at people. That's what started the Lebanese Civil War.
My mother family, this is the present situation where the Nigeria now find themselves. Nigeria have found themselves in so many terrorist ways. Now you see what is happening right now in the southeast part of Nigeria. It's no longer different from what has been happening in Lebanon. The same thing, the same forces, the same force, that is what is taking place right now. Everywhere right now is hot. Burning of cars, burning of houses, killings and all that is happening live right now in Biafra land. And tell me, somebody will say that this thing is not politicians that are doing this. These are the handwork of politicians, of which we know. This is the handwork. This is what they are known to do, and this is what they are paid to do. Later, they will be stretching accusing fingers. This is all about politics. The game that is being played here is all about politics. There is nothing anybody want to tell me. Everything that is going on right now in the southeast part of Nigeria is all politics. This is the handwork of DSS. The ones that are stealing, the ones that are killing, the ones that are just out of jealousy, they want to take power or they want their political party to produce the best candidate. They are the ones doing all this right now. If you have your eyes look down, you will know that what is going on right now is not mere talk. It's not mercy. This is the handwork of DSS. This is the handwork of Nigeria leaders. They are the ones that are in charge of this. So I just brought it to you for you to understand that a lot has been going on right now in the southeast part of Nigeria. It is hell, but God will give us a way of escape. All right, my wonderful family, thank you very much for watching and for supporting us. And if you know you haven't subscribed to this channel, do well to subscribe, like, and share. And meanwhile, remember to contact your family to stay cool and to stay well and to stay blessed, because what is going to happen right now, nobody knows. Only what and who we depend on right now is God to see us through. See you when I see you. For now, bye.